Hello everyone, in this video I am going to discuss about heat transfer and different modes of heat transfer. So if we want to define the heat transfer, so first we should know about the heat. So what is heat? So heat we usually define as a form of energy which result temperature difference. Heat is always related to temperature, and where we are considering temperature difference, it means there is a energy transfer occur, and one form of energy is transferring into another form of energy in the form of temperature difference. So that particular form of energy is called heat. So heat is what? Heat we consider as the amount of energy flowing from one body of matter to another due to temperature difference. So here temperature difference is the main reason of heat transfer. And heat transfer always happens from high temperature to lower temperature. So this is about the heat and heat transfer. Now heat transfer we can define by different modes. So what are the different modes of heat transfer? There are three modes of heat transfer we consider. One is conduction, another is convection, and third is radiation. And these all heat transfer depends on the mediums, or it depends on the system and surrounding interaction. So let's discuss about these types of modes of heat transfer. So first discuss about the conduction. Now what is conduction? So conduction is first mode of heat transfer when two bodies or two solid bodies are in direct contact. So here what we will consider? We will consider heat transfer between solid objects or solid bodies. So when two bodies are in direct contact, then heat transfer between these bodies will be represented by the conduction. Suppose, for example, we can say heat is transferring from hot burner on the stove into a pan if we are boiling water. So that is considered as the mode of heat transfer as conduction. In technical term, we can take radiators. So radiators are the example of conduction. Other example we can take as heat exchanger, or general example we can take as light bulb. So these are the example of conduction. Now let's take second type as convection. So what is convection? So convection where heat transfer happening between solid and liquid object. So here the system and surrounding are changing from solid to liquid, or from liquid to solid, or from liquid to liquid. We usually consider heat transfer because of the convection. Now we can take example as a hot steaming cup of tea. So heat is transferred from tea to the cup, hot air balloon, where the hot air filled inside the balloon, and when the air heat, it will take the balloon in the air, or it will move the balloon in upward direction. So this is the example of convection. Now another mode is called radiation. So radiation means what? It is depending on different type of rays. So basically we consider electromagnetic rays for the heat transfer. Here heat transfer occur through electromagnetic waves, or this particular radiation is happen between two bodies which are separated by empty space or gases. So in that case only radiation will occur. So the radiation is represented by the electromagnetic waves, and these electromagnetic waves will transfer only when two bodies are separated by empty space or gas. For example, microwave. So microwave oven is generally running with the help of microwaves. So that is the example of radiation where heat is producing or heat is transferring to cook the food or to heat the food. And then X-ray machines, these are the perfect example of radiation. So these are the three modes of heat transfer. With the help of these three modes, we do heat transfer in different mediums or between system and surrounding. Now here, let's discuss about the sign convention of heat transfer. See, as I have told you in previous lesson about the adiabatic process. So, adiabatic process is what? Where the heat transfer is zero. So, every system where heat transfer is happening, that should be non-adiabatic. Every system where heat transfer is possible, that system should be non-adiabatic system. So, non-adiabatic system always depends on the temperature of the surrounding. On which term it is depending? It is depending on temperature of the surrounding. So, here if we talk about work and heat both, so work is represented as a path function where work is depending on each and every characteristics which is making a particular path between two states, between initial and final state. So, work done is representing or it is depending on the path or it is depending on variation of each and every property of the system. In non-adiabatic process, if we are defining work, so it will be defined by a particular path between initial and final state. Now, if we want to define the heat transfer in non-adiabatic process, so in non-adiabatic process, other type of energy transfer have occurred because of temperature difference. First is based on the variation in properties like pressure, volume, and other type of energy interaction or energy transfer we are defining on the basis of temperature. So, that temperature difference or variation of temperature is defining the heat transfer. So, on that basis, we can say heat is also a path function because it is defining or it is depending on different value of temperature. So, this is about the heat. So, what is heat? Heat is a form of energy which is depending on temperature difference. Now, let's see the sign convention of this. So, sign convention of heat we can define on the basis of interaction between system and surrounding. So, if the heat is flowing into the system or heat is flowing from surrounding to system, so that heat transfer will be positive. And heat is flowing from the system, from system to surrounding, so that particular heat transfer will be negative. So, here we can write down, if heat flow into the system, in that case, our heat transfer will be positive. And if heat flow from the system, so our heat transfer will be negative. So, this is about heat transfer and sign convention. Now, as I told you, when heat is zero or heat transfer is zero, suppose if we have any wall and if the heat transfer into the wall or from the wall is zero, so that particular wall is called adiabatic wall. Now, suppose if we are considering heat transfer from this wall to the surrounding or from surrounding to this wall. In that case, this wall is called what? This wall is called diathermic wall. This wall is called diathermic wall. So, this is the difference between adiabatic wall and diathermic wall. Now, adiabatic process is what? Where heat transfer is zero. And diathermic process with the help of diathermic wall where heat transfer is occurring. Now, as I told you, if we have a particular process and that process is defining various properties or various characteristics, suppose this is the process, we have one and two are the initial and final state. suppose this is our process PV. So in that case, if we are considering heat transfer, so the amount of heat transfer depends on what? It always depends on intermediate state when system changes from initial to final state through which the system is passing, or every properties or every state is passing. So here every state or every point or every property is passing through that particular path of the system from initial to final state, that is representing path. And if anything depending on the path, that is called path function. So here heat transfer is also depending on different points which is passing through the path. So it means it is completely depending on path. So our heat transfer will be the path function. Okay, this thing I have already told you. Now, as I've told you, work done, if we are considering integration of work done between one and two process, so it will not become W2 minus W1. Why? Because it is depending on path. Similarly, if we want to define the change in heat transfer, so it will not be Q2 minus Q1. It will not be Q2 minus Q1. It will be similar to work done because it is a path function. It is what? It is a path function. So similar to work done, we can define this particular heat transfer between the system surrounding. So this is all about the heat transfer and modes of heat transfer. Thank you so much.